What's going on, everyone? This is Necrostevo, and today I present to you a beginner's guide to Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. Now, whether you're a newcomer to Pokemon, and these are your first Pokemon games, or you first played with Pokemon X and Y, or you played Ruby, Sapphire, and Emerald way back 10 years ago, things have changed since then. And I just wanted to give a couple of tips to help smooth out your journey. There may be some things that are just new mechanics that you didn't know about because they don't make them very prevalent. But either way, I hope you find this video helpful. If you do find it helpful, feel free to spread it around. If you have other questions, feel free to leave them in the comments and I'll get to them when I can. And be sure to leave a like button so that more people can see this video and hopefully they can find it helpful as well. Now, before you even get started, make sure you transfer items from the demo at least once per day, or rather once per day. You can only do it once per day, but you can only send one thing at a time. So if you played the demo all 10 or 11, if you got the secret nugget item times, then you can only send one item a day. And some of those items like Pokeballs or potions are going to be more useful early on when you first start playing Aurus than if you transfer, say, your Glalie or something like that up. Secondly, make sure you don't forget to download your shiny Beldum. There is actually an event right now. If you go onto your log on to Wi-Fi and then say on the intro screen there, just pop on down to Mystery Gift and download from the internet. And you can download a shiny Beldum. It'll be available for pickup at the Pokemon Center at any time after you download it, but make sure you download it before January. Secondly, one of the other new things that have been in this the set of 3DS games, when you purchase Pokeballs, Great Balls, or Ultra Balls, make sure you do it in sets of 10 to make sure you get a Premier Ball for free. Why not just grab an extra Pokeball every now and then? A Premier Ball does the same thing as a Pokeball. It just has a different design and it has a different animation when the ball opens up. Looks pretty cool. Why not grab it when you can? Now, your Dex Nav. That's a new feature, as are many of the features on the lower screen. The Dex Nav has a lot of new features, but the things I want to point out specifically are that you're making sure you use it very often. The Dex Nav will not only tell you when you have captured every Pokemon in the area, it'll have a little crown in the corner that can go from bronze to silver to gold to platinum to tell you if you've captured all the Pokemon in an area and in all the different ways you can capture them, including the hidden ones. Furthermore, the Dex Nav tells you how close you are to Pokemon when you're trying to sneak up to them, so pay attention to the arrows on the screen at the bottom. If there are four arrows, then of course the Pokemon is likely on the screen, whereas if there aren't that many arrows, then you might have to walk around a little bit to find them. Also, the more you encounter Pokemon, the better Pokemon the Dex Nav will find for you. You'll find Pokemon that have hidden abilities, unusual moves, and sometimes even held items. For example, I found a Lotad with Teeter Dance, and I've also found a couple of Gloom with Absorb Bulbs through the Dex Nav. So the more often you encounter Pokemon, the better Pokemon you will encounter through Dex Nav. When you do find Pokemon through Dex Nav, you may notice that Pokemon have a star rating. The star rating refers to the IVs that the Pokemon has. There is one star, they have one perfect IV, two star, two perfect IVs, and three stars means three perfect IVs. This is useful if you're capturing Pokemon for breeding, or if you just want a good Pokemon for going through your journey with. Now, make sure when you get to New Mauville, you scour that city very thoroughly. There are a lot of useful items there besides just the bike. In New Mauville, you can not only purchase the Luck Incense, which allows you to get double money in battles if you give it to a held as a held item to a Pokemon. You get that a lot more early than you would get the Amulet Coin from your mother. But also, in New Mauville, you get your new O-Powers. You get those O-Powers from there's a bald-headed guy, or actually they're all twins, guys, in the New Mauville, or rather the Mauville Pokemon Center. Just go and talk to him, agree to everything he says, no matter how weird it sounds, and look at you, your new O-Powers. Once you've gotten all the O-Powers, you can get the final O-Power by going to their apartment, but that's not until much later in the game. Of course, the O-Powers are located on the bottom screen on the Play Online with Others screen, and you hit the little circle, and you can actually level up each of your O-Powers, and the way to level them up is to just use them. I highly recommend playing online so that you can use your O-Powers on other players, because using them on other players will cut the cost in half, and it'll give some people a chance to use their powers on you, and everyone can help everyone else out, level up your powers, and you'll get a lot more usage out of them. Another tip I have is just to utilize a Zigzagoon or a Linoon. Early on in the game, it's probably the first Pokemon you're going to encounter outside of the Poochyena that you encounter to help out Professor Birch. Zigzagoon and Linoon have a pickup ability, which allows you to have a chance of finding an item after every battle. Not only is this useful for getting just random good items or random items that you may or may not need, but as you level up Zigzagoon and Linen, you're going to be finding better and better items. This can range from finding a potion to a full restore or a max revive or rare candies and leftovers. You'll get all that when they level up more. But all early on in your journey, finding repels, super repels, and potions and super potions, and sometimes even heart skills can be quite useful. Furthermore, Zigzagoon and Linoon are fantastic for HMs. Zigzagoon and Linoon are relatively fast. Also, they can learn almost all of the HMs. They're missing out on a couple, such as Fly and Defog. Of course, Defog is no longer an HM. Not sure why I said that. But they can utilize several of the other HMs. So since the game is so HM reliant, putting several of those HMs on one Pokemon that you're going to have with you anyway for pickup can allow you to be a little bit more efficient with your team setup. Finally, I recommend surfing with Sharpedo. If you go and surf, then you'll see that you're going to spend a lot of your time surfing in the late game, and you feel like it's moving a little bit slow. Sharpedo actually moves over twice as fast as surfing with any other Pokemon. If you are trying to sneak up on some Pokemon, I do not recommend using Sharpedo because he moves so quickly in the water. It's difficult to sneak up on Pokemon in the water unless you're very tender with a C-Stick. And if you do need a Pokemon that's useful for sneaking up on other Pokemon in the water, I recommend Kyogre as it has a much larger sprite in the water. Therefore, it makes it easier to come into contact with Pokemon when you're trying to sneak up on them. I hope these tips have been helpful, and I will be posting another video for post-game tips. But if you guys have anything else you need from me, be sure to leave it in the comments, and I'll get to it when I get a moment. Have a great day, be sure to leave a like, and I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.